हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डी एड एम ए। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत अच्छे से चल रहे हैं। तो इस रिवीजन सीरीज़ में हम कंटिन्यू कर रहे हैं साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी से। सो दिस इज़ पार्ट 32 ऑफ द वीडियो। होप यू हैव सीन द अदर 31 पार्ट्स एंड होप वी आर हेल्पिंग यू आउट इन योर प्रिपरेशन। ओके, सो जस्ट मेक यूज़ ऑफ द बेस्ट अवेलेबल ऑफ द रिसोर्सेज। कीप योर रिसोर्सेज लिमिटेड। रिवाइज वॉट यू हैव बीन रीडिंग थरोली कंटिन्यूसली। ओके, सो दिस विल इंश्योर दैट यू नो यू जस्ट just become better at what you're doing. This will ensure that you do the things thoroughly. Okay, so having thorough knowledge and having confidence in what you read is very much important during the examination, because you'll be already in a lot of stress and all. If you don't have enough confidence while doing things, you know that with that can go against you in the examination, because you know, as you know, each and every mark is very important, each and every question is very important. Okay, so हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी से। तो दिस इज पार्ट 32 ऑफ द लेक्चर। होप यू हैव सीन द 31 पार्ट्स। तो इस लेक्चर में हम कवर करते हैं वेरियस साइंस एंड वेरियस करंट अफेयर्स से। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट बायो फोर्टिफाइड क्रॉप्स। सो बायो फोर्टिफाइड क्रॉप्स, वॉट इज बायो फोर्टिफिकेशन? एज आई टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी, बायो फोर्टिफिकेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ इंक्रीजिंग द न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू ऑफ द फूड क्रॉप्स। इंक्रीजिंग न्यूट्रिशनल कंटेंट आर्टिफिशियली इन द फूड क्रॉप्स इज बायो फोर्टिफिकेशन। वी आर फोर्टिफाइंग द फूड विद इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड विटामिन्स, दैट इज वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर अस। सो बायो फोर्टिफिकेशन इज नथिंग बट इंक्रीजिंग द न्यूट्रिशनल वैल्यू ऑफ द फूड। सो रिसेंटली बायो फोर्टिफाइड कैरेट वेराइटी मधुबान गाजर वॉज कल्टिवेटेड एंड डेवलप्ड बाय वल्लभाई वासराम भाई मरवेनिया, अ फार्मर साइंटिस्ट फ्रॉम जूनागढ़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ गुजरात। जूनागढ़ इज इन गुजरात। सो दिस पर्सन वल्लभाई वासराम भाई मरवेनिया हैज डेवलप्ड दिस बायो फोर्टिफाइड कैरेट मधुबन गाजर। मधुबन गाजर इज द बायो फोर्टिफाइड कैरेट। ओके, नेक्स्ट वन, द PCPNDT एक्ट। सो दिस वॉज इन न्यूज़। This was in news because recently, you know, a lot of media and everyone felt that the rules of this has been diluted. Everyone felt that. Okay, so this PCPNDT Act, the prenatal diagnostic technique Act, PCPNDT Act was an act which was launched to curb the declining sex ratio. So that you know the diagnostics which was done in order to determine the sex of the unborn baby, so this is curbed. The Minister of Health and Family Welfare has clarified that it has not suspended the act, because the issue is that so during lockdown, the Minister of Health and Family Welfare has issued a notification to defer certain provisions of the PCPNDT rules. Certain provisions are deferred, but not the act. The act is in place intact. Because when, you know, in 1990s, when it was seen that the sex ratio of India has been declining, then this act has been introduced. This act has been introduced to curb the declining sex ratio. These rules pertain to applying for renewal of registration if failing during this period, submission of reports by diagnostic centers by 5th day of the following month, and submission of quarterly progress reports. So generally, they will have to submit certain reports to the government, but these reports, you know, their submission has been delayed. That's why this was in news. The PCPNDT Act, what is this act? This act, as I told you, it was enacted in response to the declining sex ratio in India, which deteriorated from 972 in 1901 to 927 in 1991. And the main purpose of this act is to ban the use of sex selection technique before or after conception and prevent the misuse of prenatal diagnostic technique for sex selective abortion. You know, the conducting PND test for any purpose other than one mentioned in the act, sale, distribution, supply, renting, etc. of any ultrasound machine or any other equipment which is capable of detecting sex of the fetus is banned. It was amended in 2003 to improve the regulation of the technology which is used in the sex selection. Okay, this is about the PCPNDT Act. It was passed in the parliament, so it's a statutory act. Next one, World Chagas Disease Day. The World Chagas Disease Day is observed on 14th of April 2020 for the first time. This is to spread awareness about the silent and silenced diseases. There are some silent and silent diseases because a lot of people don't talk about it and very few people get affected by these. So in order to make sure that awareness about these diseases is spread, we have observed this World Chagas Disease Day. So the Chagas disease is called silent because it progresses slowly, and silenced because mainly it affects the poor people who often lack political voice and proper health care. Okay, Next one, Software Technology Parks of India. The Software Technology Parks of India, it was launched in 1991, this program. This is to promote software technology parks. Okay, recently it was in news because the rental payments and everything has been deferred by the companies that are in this Software Technology Park of India premises. Okay, this STPA, Software Technology Park of India, is a autonomous body under the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, established in 1991. Okay, the governing council chairperson is the Union Minister of Electronics and Information Technology, is the governing council, you know, chairman. Next one, Tribo E masks and Tribo electricity. So a team of researchers from Nano and Soft Matter Sciences, CNES, Bangalore, which is an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology, they have come up with a recipe of making face masks termed as Tribo E mask that can hold electric charges to restrict and the entry of infections, but interestingly without any external power. So they have developed this. So when a person uses this mask, it will be electrically charged, and this charge, you know, it will capture if any infections are coming, this charge will capture that and it will kill that. Okay, next one, Feluda. Feluda is a low cost paper strip test which can detect the new coronavirus within an hour. So what is Feluda, if it asked? It's a low cost paper strip test. It is developed by CSIR, the Institute of Genomics and Integrated Biology, CSIR IGIB. Okay, so this is very low cost also. It costs around 500 against the RT-PCR test, which cost 4,500 rupees in the private labs. This test, this low cost Feluda, this test is based on a bacterial immune system protein called Cas9. So it uses the cutting edge gene editing tool CRISPR-Cas9 system. Okay, so it uses a genome cutting and pasting technique called CRISPR-Cas9. So Feluda is a low-cost paper strip test developed by the CSIR, Institute of Genomics and Integrated Biology, CSIR IGIB. Now, what is CRISPR technology? The CRISPR-Cas9 is a technology, it's a basic gene editing technology. It's a gene editing technology, that means it is used to edit the genes. It is used to cutting and pasting of genes. So generally, the DNA strands will be like this. Okay, so in these strands, there will be defective genes somewhere. So what they will do this in this technology, the defective genes are, they will cut these defective genes and they will paste the proper genes. So the defective genes can be removed. That is this gene editing technology. So this is used for targeting specific stretches of an entirely genetic code or editing the DNA at a particular location. It has many potential applications, including correcting genetic defects, treating and preventing the spread of diseases, and improving crops. Next one, World Malaria Day. The World Malaria Day is observed by the WHO. It's on April 25th. World Malaria Day is on April 25th. So the theme is Zero Malaria Starts With Me. The theme for 2020 is Zero Malaria Starts With Me. It's celebrated on April 25th. The malaria is caused by a parasite that commonly infects a certain type of mosquito which feeds on humans, and the female Anopheles mosquito is that mosquito which spreads the malaria. Okay, it deposits parasite sporozoites into the skin of a human host. Parasite sporozoites. Okay, so malaria is caused by parasite. Next one is about the Vizag gas leak. So there was recently a gas leak in a plant in Vizag that has killed 8 people. And a lot of people has been hospitalized. So the leak occurred from LG Polymers Private Limited, which is a South Korean corporation, LG Polymers Private Limited. So the gas which was leaked is a styrene gas. Okay, the styrene is a gas which is used for it's a poisonous gas which is used for making polymers. Okay, so the leak is mainly because of overheating, which led to pipe leaks. So when they were about to start the plant after the lockdown, so this happened. Okay, now what is styrene? Styrene is a poisonous inflammable gas. It is used in the production of polystyrene, plastic and resin, and in the food packing, rubber, plastic, insulation, fiberglass, pipes and automobiles. So this has various, you know, various applications. This is about the Vizag gas leak. Next, Troglomyces twitteri. Recently, a new species has been discovered using the Twitter image, and thus it has been named as Troglomyces twitteri. So as this was discovered using a Twitter image, the name was placed based on the Twitter name. So Troglomyces twitteri is a specific type of parasitic fungus belongs to an order called Lobolibinales. Lobolibinales. It's a tiny fungal parasite that attacks insects and millipedes. Okay, that is why this was in news. Okay, now let's just revise what we have studied till now. We have seen about the biofortified crops. The biofortified crops are those crops whose nutritional value is increased. Nutritional value is increased artificially. And recently, Madhuban Gajar was developed by farmer scientist Vallabhai Vasarambhai Marvinia at Junagadh in Gujarat. Okay, next one. Next one is about the It's a PCPNDT Act. The PCPNDT Act is passed. It was passed to make sure that the sex selection is aborted. Sex selection is not taken place. Next one, World Chagas Day. World Chagas Day is observed on 14th of April 2020 every year. This is where the first time this we have observed this World Chagas Day. And it is called silent because it progresses slowly and is silenced because only the poor gets affected by this disease. Next one, we saw about the Software Technology Park of India, which was launched in 1991. This scheme is to promote the software technology parks in India. Okay, next one, we saw about the Tribo E-Mass and Tribo Electricity. The team of researchers from Nano and Soft Matter Sciences, Bangalore, which is an autonomous institute under the Department of Science and Technology, has come up with this recipe for making face masks. Okay, this is where in which an electric pulse is being produced, electric power is sent to it, and using artificial batteries so that this electricity will capture the viruses that are entering. And the next we talked about Feluda, which is a low cost paper strip test for detecting of a coronavirus. This is very low cost. It is just 500 rupees compared to that of 4500 rupees charged for the RT-PCR test. Next, it is developed by the CSIR scientist in the Institute of Genomics and Integrated Biology, CSIR IGIB. Next, we saw about the CRISPR technology. CRISPR-Cas9 is a gene editing technology. Okay, so this is a technology where the genes are cut and they'll cut the genes and paste the genes. That is this kind of technology. Next, we talked about the World Malaria Day. The World Malaria Day is observed on 25th of April, and the theme for this year is Zero Malaria Starts With Me. Okay, and the malaria is spread by a female Anopheles mosquito. Next one, we talked about the Vizag gas leak. The styrene gas leak happened in Vizag, which has caused 8 deaths and a lot of people has been hospitalized. The gas has been leaked in LG Polymers Limited. It is mainly due to the overheating and which led to pipe leaks. So next we talked about Trogomyces twitteri, which is a new species discovered, and it was named after Twitter because it was discovered by a Twitter image. Okay, so that's it friends in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.